Ramdeo, so shall we rule out anything on GST or DTC in this budget, which can be construed as market positive?
No, actually, we are expecting some pronouncements, definitive announcements.
On which? Which one?
On GST as well as CST, I mean DTC. But, you know, expectations are running low, but I don't think he can, because these are two big reforms. I mean, I would say three: petroleum, your DTC, and GST. Something has to move, otherwise, I think it will be, in any case, numbers have no meaning. In this kind of uncertain environment where you don't know what is going to be the growth, what is going to be your deficit, how much will be subsidy, how much you are willing to collect from the people. So with that, any kind of a jugglery with the number is completely meaningless. I think the concrete action on the ground, that okay, let's move on this, let's deregulate this, let's... So I think those are things which people are looking for.
DTC, Ashok, a quick word from you.
Yeah, I personally believe that you will see a firm announcement on DTC. The last draft of DTC is under review by the government, is expected to be discussed in the monsoon session, and the final draft will be put out for public review before it's incorporated in the 2012 budget. So I think you will see a very definitive statement on the introduction of DTC, and you will actually see changes in direct tax code this year, whatever changes are made, the few ones that are made, will converge towards DTC. So I do expect the surcharge will be removed, partly because DTC says 30%, and partly because they've already waived surcharge on some taxpayers last year. I don't see MAT changing at all. I don't see any change in capital gains tax, because all of these converge to DTC. I see some of the sunset clauses related to tax exemption, particularly for SEZs, the IT sector, as well as the power generation sector, which had a sunset for 2011 March, and where if DTC had originally come in April 1, were going to be grandfathered for 3 years. I do see those extensions being granted, such that as DTC is introduced in 2012, the sunset clause automatically merges into the 3-year grandfathering. So I do see an affirmative statement on DTC. I do see some tax changes all converging towards DTC. And that, I think, will be, as Ramdev pointed out, a very positive step, because at least one of the three big reforms will have got clear sunlight.
Mm. Ilesh, the market's crying for something which it can latch on to as a positive intent on reform. Is there anything which the government can do or is likely to do which will be construed as, okay, finally some reform?
There are lots of things which government can do. I mean, for example, Provident Fund and Pension Fund. For almost a decade plus, Ministry of Finance has approved investment in equities by pension funds. The difference between equity return and fixed income return weighs heavily for pension fund to invest in equity markets. Ministry of Labour is opposing. Just two arms of the government can't reconcile these things over 10 years. They can sort out that difference. The second thing is related to, you know, when we are saying that our taxation structure, when we have 10% tax to GDP ratio, it's one of the lowest in the world. One, our tax structure is quite complicated. Second, the governance or enforcement of taxation rules are, you know, quite difficult. Now, there could be some steps on that matter which can result into better taxation. So many things which is outside of TaxNet can be brought into the TaxNet through just governance, not regulation, just governance. And there could be a special focus on that. If you do that focus, suddenly your taxation to GDP ratio moves from 10 to 11 or 11 to 12, and you can then take care of some parts of the subsidy. The third thing is related to UID project. Now, we have seen the effectiveness of NREGS when the payment has been made by bank account and post office accounts rather than cash payment. Now, can that be extended to various other forms of subsidies where it's going directly to the user rather than through intermediary? So there is a wastage in the expenditure, there is a leakage in the revenue. Can you put some direction? We won't achieve 100% on day one, but remove the leakages, plug the wastages, and then suddenly you have a budget which will cheer the market, because market has least expectation from the budget.
Sure. Ramdeo, what about magic words like FDI and insurance and multi-brand retail? Maybe just signaling, but do you expect that to happen?
But signaling has been happening for such a long time, year after year. You know, there is so much of dearth of actual action on the ground, and hence the budget per se is a set of promises. It doesn't do anything on the ground. So we need whether budget or no budget, but actual action on the ground. When you talk about financial sector reform or anything changing, let's change it rather than just talk about it. So I think what has happened is that it has become a day on which a lot of promises are made. But when you review, I think a more appropriate thing would be to review what has been promised in last budget and what has been the action taken report kind of thing in last 12 months. I mean, the bigger initiatives, whether how much progress we have done in that. And when you look at that, I think progress is very little. So I think this, and one other thing is that now the government's own investment targets are very little in the budget. Rest all is all kind of expenditure, which in any case you have to do it. The salaries and defense and all those kind of things. So there is very little, except for the policy initiative, there is very little finance minister actually can do it.
This is a common criticism, Nirmal, that, you know, a lot of promises at the end of the year, nothing is achieved. General cynicism about what the budget is about.
I mean, that's what coalition government has been all about in the last 10 years, or last 8 years at least. But in this budget, I'm a little optimistic on FDI for a couple of reasons. One is, a current account deficit has already reached the level of 1991. And our government and our, normally when we are pushed into a crisis, they act. And also it can further aggravate given the crude oil, the way it's behaving. What government desperately needs is long-term capital by way of, primarily by way of equity. So I think this will be a good reason for government to push through some of the FDI reforms which have been pending for a long time.
But can it get it passed?
I maybe the retail will be lesser of a problem with the, in any case, Communist Party is not part of coalition. So I think they might try with retail. Insurance is difficult in this environment, but I think retail is something possible tomorrow.
What do you think, Ashok? FDI insurance, multi-brand retail?
You know, if there is one thing that the government can do, and you know, part of the signal again came from President's speech in the parliament for the budget opening of the budget session.
Oh, you listened to that seriously as well?
Well, you know, I take cues from it.
Okay.
And there was
there was
emphasis on FDI in that budget speech. I haven't heard a president actually speak about FDI in the many years that I have heard the pre-budget speech. You know, my own view is that that's clearly one action which will show decisiveness and which has the ability to change both the sentiment and the pool of capital. I mean, if you make the change in the insurance sector from 26 to 49, that brings in $10 billion of long-term capital into this country in a sector that genuinely needs that capital. I think it will also ease pressure on Indian promoters who have otherwise to fund the balance of that capital, and you know, to the extent that they're putting it into insurance ventures, it's going out of somewhere else. So I think insurance is certainly one area which I hope he does it. Can he do it? I think he can do it. Will he do it? Well, let's see. We'll know it on Monday. Multi-brand is the other area which we've been talking about. I actually think that in some ways multi-brand is a little more difficult, given that, you know, this is election year in 5 states, and you know, the retailing business does affect a lot of vote contributors. Having said that, there's been a lot of discussion, and it's time we see some action from the government in that area. And the last one, of course, is the banking sector reform, where again, you know, decent amount of FDI and local investment can go in. We hope that there is some clear announcement on who's entitled to and who's not entitled to the new licenses. There's been a lot of uncertainty vis-a-vis that. Will corporate India get licenses, or will big business...
In the budget, you think?
You remember the announcement for licenses, that new licenses will be issued, came in the budget.
That's true.
And any clarification, therefore, related to that in terms of whether business houses will or will not get it, and you know, what's the exact rules or what's the time frame. These are small changes, but again, these are changes that make a big impact on the sentiment. The only other thing I would say, agreeing with all my other panelists, is what we really need now in the government is not just a planning commission, but an implementation commission, which then takes responsibility for saying, this is what the finance minister said, and we will now ensure that on a month-to-month basis or quarter-to-quarter basis. Maybe they need to appoint Supreme Court to take charge of that, and then we will see some certain action.